So we'll be going back and forth between those two objects. And when you work on correcting subject verb agreement problems, you want to follow these steps. First, find the subject of the sentence. Make sure it's not a prepositional phrase. Second, replace the subject with a pronoun. He, she, it, they, I, we. And then see if you need an S or an irregular form of the verb in order to make them agree. Okay? So let's try that with the first sentence. A good scientist observes closely and records data accurately. What's the subject? The subject is scientist. Scientist. Scientist would be replaced with he or she. Right? So we have he or she observes. That's correct. But look, this is a compound verb. Record. So this person got the S on their first verb, but they didn't get the S on the second verb. And that's a very common mistake with verb endings, that we get it on the first one, but not the second one. So records data accurately. Okay? Is the correct form. So in that problem, let's look at this sentence to analyze. Each semester, Kathleen tells her students to bring a pen to the ESSAWAT test. The subject is Kathleen. So she. She tell or she tells? You should say tells. Okay, and this problem means that we need to use a final S on a verb in the third person singular, he, she, or it form of the present tense. Okay, let's look at the next problem. Taking regular breaks often help people work more efficiently. What's the subject of this sentence? Sometimes people think the subject is breaks, okay? But actually, the subject of this sentence is taking. Remember that a gerund, an ing word, can be the subject of a sentence, like running is fun. So taking, an ing word, we replace with it. And the verb in this sentence is help. So do we say it help? No, we say it helps. You see how making sure you have the right subject is important. If you thought the subject of the sentence was breaks, that would be a plural subject, they. So you would say they help. But since the real subject is taking, we have to say taking is it, so we say it helps. So it really does make a difference. Let's see how we analyze this in another example. Taking tests causes stress for students. Again, the subject is not tests. The subject is taking, which is it. So we say it cause or it causes. It causes stress for students. Okay? Here's another example. Taking tests and writing papers were or was my least favorite activities in college. What's the subject here? Well, the subject is actually a compound subject, taking and writing. Taking and writing. So since there's two subjects, we'd replace it with they. So do we say they were or they was? They were my least favorite activities in college. Okay? So remember, when you have two or more subjects like taking and writing, we need to use a plural verb. Let's look at the example here. Ecuador and Brazil is playing in the Copa America. Here we have, what's the subject here? It's a compound subject, right? Ecuador and Brazil. So Ecuador and Brazil, we would replace with they. Do we say they is playing? No. We say they are playing in the Copa America. All right, let's look at the next example since we're here. Saturday or Sunday are the day of the party. Okay? When we have sentences with or, it has special rules. So we actually need to change are here to is. Because when we have sentences with or nor, whichever subject is closer to the verb, we need to agree with it. So the subject that's closer to the verb is Sunday. That's it, singular. So we have to say it is, not it are. Here's some more examples back on the PowerPoint. Okay, either the students or the teacher have or has to leave. So we have a sentence with or. We have to look at the subject that's after or, which is the teacher. That's he or she. Do we say he or she have or he or she has? Hopefully you said has. Okay, here's another example, this time using nor. Okay, so these sentences with or nor have special rules. Neither the teacher nor the students have or has enough time. Here, the noun that's closer, the subject that's closer, is students. That's they. So do we say they have or they has? Hopefully you said have. with either or neither nor, the verb agrees with the noun that's closest to it. Okay, let's go back to our pretest to look at the next example. One of the two cars consumes significantly more gas than the other. So if you think the subject of this sentence is two cars, you would say they consume, and that sounds right. But unfortunately, that's not the subject. Why? Of the two cars is the prepositional phrase, when the subject of the sentence is actually one, so it's like it. So do we say it consume or it consumes? We say it consumes. Okay, here's another example. This is from the chart that you are supposed to memorize. Everyone like to have the day off from work. Everyone is the subject of the sentence, and actually everyone is a singular subject. It always counts like he or she. So do we say he or she like or he or she likes? We say likes. Okay, so that's another correction. Let's look at a few more examples in our PowerPoint. Okay, all of the SOWHAT information is or are on Blackboard. With phrases like all of the, we have to see what the head noun is, which is information. That's it. That's singular. So we should say it is on Blackboard. Okay, all of the tests is or are in students' files. So in this time we need to analyze tests, which is plural, they. So we should say they is or they are. They are. Okay, so rules for subject-verb agreement vary depending on the quantifying words or phrases. Okay, so when we have all of the, none of the, or some, use a singular verb if the noun is uncountable, and use a plural verb if the noun is plural. Okay, so all of the advice is it, non-countable, it makes. Use a plural verb if the noun is plural. None of the students is plural, they make. Okay, for these ones, we always use a singular verb. That means we always replace it with he, she, or it. One of the, everyone, each, everybody, someone, anyone, anybody, no one, nobody, anything, something, nothing, or another. You can memorize these. It's great to have something to memorize since writing is sometimes so tricky and we can't really memorize things. Okay, here we go. So here we have number 7. There is 6 articles that I need to review this week in preparation for my presentation. Hopefully you remember that there can't be the subject of a sentence, and that in sentences with there is or there are, the subject comes after the verb. So the actual subject here would be articles. This is plural, they. So do we say they is? No. We say there are. So we have to change this one to are. Okay? Okay, let's go ahead and look at that. There is or are several reasons why the ESL department developed the SOWHAT test. Here we have the subject, reasons. That's plural subject, they. So we should say they is or they are. Are. Okay, so when a sentence or clause begins with there, the verb agrees with the subject, which is after the verb. Okay? Here's another example I'm going to show on the pretest first. An attorney from one of the most distinguished law firms have agreed to represent the subject. What's the subject of this sentence? Is it firms? Law firms? No, because that is part of a prepositional phrase. Is it one? No, because that's part of a prepositional phrase beginning with from. So the actual subject of this sentence is attorney. Attorney. Attorney is another word for lawyer. So we'd replace it with he, she. So do we say he have agreed? No, we say he has agreed. Okay, let's look at one more example while we're here. A supervisor who listens to others and whose style is collaborative is often the most effective. We can tell that supervisor is the subject of the sentence, and it would be replaced with he, she. So he, she, the main verb here is, right? And this whole phrase, who listened to others, is part of an adjective clause, or a clause that's describing supervisor. However, as you can see from the underlining on this verb, the verb that's in the clause still needs to agree with the subject. So do we say he or she listen or he or she listens? We should say listens. Okay? So let's go back and look at these a little bit on our PowerPoint. The members of the Ethel Watt Committee create or creates numerous topics for students to write about. The subject of this sentence is not committee, because that's part of the prepositional phrase. The subject is members, plural, they. So do we say they create or they creates? You should say create. Okay, so make sure the verb agrees with the subject, not the extra information like of the Ethel Watt Committee. Here's another example. A professor who serves on the committee has been teaching writing for 25 years. The subject, professor, is singular, he, she. So do we say he or she serve or he or she serves? We say serves. Okay? And that's the example like the last one on your pretest. When you have an adjective clause like who, the verb in there still needs to agree with the subject. So those are the basics of subject-verb agreement. We'll be doing more practice in the next video.